This is a Pioneer CT-W616DR, introduced in 1996, which was well after the heyday of cassette decks. By 1996, there were already CD recorders on the market, and there were also CD recordable drives for your computer, so you could record music onto your sound card on your computer and burn it to a CD, just like people do these days. Of course, it was more expensive than using a cassette deck, but that kind of digital technology was already on the consumer market at the time, and cassettes were already pretty much considered obsolete. They were still selling well, but mostly for people to play in their cars and in their Walkmans. At home, most people listened to CDs. So cassettes were really on their way out in the late 90s, but Pioneer decided to give it one last try with these cassette decks, which have a very special feature. It says it right here, digital processing system, 20-bit analog to digital and digital to analog converter. So what this cassette deck does is take the analog audio on the tape, convert it to digital, then it does digital processing on the audio and converts it back to analog to provide the output through the output jacks and the headphone jack. Would have been nice if this had a digital output like an optical connector, but unfortunately it does not. You can see another feature mentioned here, digital flex, and flex stands for frequency level expander. What that does, it measures the frequency response of the cassette as it's being played, and if it detects that the high frequencies are lacking, such as on an old worn out tape or a cheap tape that wasn't very good to begin with, it boosts the high frequencies to make it sound better. But in case it brightens it too much for your liking, you could turn it off with the button here. There was a similar model, the CT-W606DR, which did not have the flex feature, at least in North America, because the manual here actually mentions that, lists the features, and it says flex button except for US model of the W606DR. Also mentions BLEXD. That's for recording. It automatically adjusts the bias, the level, and the equalization. And the XD stands for extended dynamic range. And again, it mentions that if you have the US model of the W606DR, you will not have the BLEXD system for recording. So this cassette deck clearly has a lot of bells and whistles, but the one thing I have not mentioned so far is the digital noise reduction system that it has, developed by Pioneer. It says it's an innovative system capable of reducing almost all hiss noise, regardless of how the tape being played was recorded. So in other words, you do not need a tape encoded with Dolby NR. There it mentions the frequency response, which is very good for a cassette deck. With a metal tape, you can get the same frequency response as a CD player, 20 to 20,000 hertz. Here's the signal to noise ratio with digital NR on. When you're playing a tape that's Dolby B or C encoded, you get 90 dB, which is almost as good as a CD. A CD gives you 96 dB. And when you're playing a tape that was not encoded with Dolby, you get 82 dB, which is better than any regular cassette deck with Dolby C noise reduction. So this will give you almost CD quality audio from any cassette, regardless if it was encoded with Dolby noise reduction or not. The one thing this is lacking is Dolby S noise reduction, which was the best form of Dolby NR ever offered on cassette decks. And I've heard Dolby S noise reduction and it does work very, very well. But on this deck, when you combine Dolby B or C with this digital noise reduction, I think it gets equally as good as Dolby S. And in fact, I recorded a demo of this cassette deck playing some tapes, some recorded with Dolby B and some just plain without any Dolby. And I uploaded that to my music channel. I'll include a link to that in the description to this video if you want to take a listen to it. This also does not offer DBX noise reduction, which was a competitor system to Dolby, but that system pretty much died out by the 90s. So you really only find that on cassette decks from the early to mid 80s at the latest. Otherwise, this is a pretty fully loaded cassette deck. You get auto reverse and full logic controls on both decks. Otherwise, you get automatic tape type selection, and you get that automatic bias level and equalization setting when you're recording. And it's doing its own little demo here. The way you activate that is by pushing these two buttons at the same time. Then it goes into demo mode. Most Pioneer products did have a demo mode. I know their CD changers had a similar feature on them. Now, as for that digital noise reduction system, it does work extremely well, although in certain situations, especially on tapes that were not recorded with Dolby, during the quieter parts of the recording, you can hear some artifacts from the filtering it's doing. But at least to me, I'd rather hear those artifacts than the tape hiss, especially on a Type 1 tape without any Dolby. But in case you do not like the way that the digital noise reduction system sounds, there is a way to defeat it just by pressing both of the time count buttons at the same time. You can see the digital light turned off, and that's how you turn off the digital noise reduction system, although you can still use the flex feature and the automatic BLE XD system even with digital noise reduction turned off. I don't think anybody's going to be dubbing tapes anymore, but in case you do, this thing has a feature called Digital TDNS, Tape Duplication Noise Suppressor System. Basically what it does, it takes the audio from the tape that's being copied, the playback audio, and it applies that digital noise reduction to it. So it cleans up the sound before it's being recorded to the tape you're recording onto. That helps to reduce the hiss noise that is multiplied when you copy one tape to another, because normally you get the hiss not only from the tape you're recording to, but the hiss that was in the playback of the tape you're playing. So this way, it says, it reduces the hiss noise in the master tape by applying digital NR processing and the bias noise by decreasing the recording bias amount while the played music signal is in the no signal condition. As a result, the noise in the middle of the music is equivalent to the master tape, and the noise between music can be reduced. But you can turn this off just like you can turn off the digital NR when playing a tape in case you don't like the way it sounds. And I think I forgot to mention, this also has Dolby HX Pro, which is not a noise reduction encoding system, it's a headroom extension system. And if you want to read how it works, you can pause the video on this little blurb here. And what better way to demonstrate this cassette deck than with more smooth jazz from another CT-W616DR sampler tape? I was able to find it on eBay this time, just happened to come up in the search results. And I listened to this, and I think it was recorded without any Dolby, because I tried playing it with Dolby B noise reduction turn on, and it sounds terrible. And it's also a regular Type 1 tape. You can tell by the brown color of the tape. Chrome tape looks almost black in comparison. So this is a very good test of this digital noise reduction system, because it's the worst case scenario of a Type 1 tape with no Dolby encoding. So I'll give you a few samples of how this sounds.
Sit back and relax and escape from the ordinary with our smooth jazz sampler, music you'll only hear on CT-W616DR.
Somebody.
This is just a sample of the wide variety of unique music that you'll hear every day on CD101.9. No rap, no tired oldies, no hard rock. We keep the mood right with smooth jazz. That's our promise to you.
Here's more of the unique blend of music that you'll only hear on one radio station, CD 101.9.
CD 101.9.
I'm in a New York state of mind.
We hope you've enjoyed this sample of the special music you'll always hear on CD 101.9. Smooth jazz in long, extended CD sets played back-to-back all day. Unique music for people with very special tastes.
And as for getting one of these cassette decks for yourself, they're not exactly plentiful, because like I mentioned, these were produced when cassettes were already going out of favor in the late 90s. But you can find them. It's always a gamble when buying used cassette decks, because they're such highly mechanical machines. There's so many things that can go wrong with them. And you really should know how to do basic maintenance, like cleaning and demagnetizing the heads and adjusting the azimuth. There's a video I'll link to which has a very good tutorial on how to do that. And you may also sometimes need to replace the belts in these things. And that varies a lot with different makes and models, so it's not really possible to give a one-size-fits-all tutorial on how to do that. You really need to sort of look it up for your specific model and see if anybody else has already provided instructions on how to do that. Otherwise, it may take some experimenting on how to get that done. And obviously, you'll need to measure the belts and order replacements if you need to do that. But unless some manufacturer starts making good cassette decks again, which I kind of doubt will happen, this is something that cassette fans will have to learn how to do, as these higher quality cassette decks from the 80s and 90s become increasingly old and they require more service over time. But in my case, I did not need to do any repairs or maintenance on this cassette deck. I didn't even have to open the cover, so if you shop carefully, you should be able to find one of these in very good condition.
Thanks for taking the time to listen to our station music sampler. Whether you listen at home, in the car, or while you're working, depend on CD101.9 to create an exceptional environment with smooth jazz.
listen as soon as you can. And be sure to set a button on your car radio, too.